let me show ya.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of VP Customs. This is going to be part two of the handlebar install. If you haven't seen part one, you can see the link. We'll put it down below. I think we're able to put like a clip of the video or something in there for you guys to click back to. So go check that out. That's going to be the full disassembly of the handlebars. This is going to be part two, where I'd say the fun stuff. Now we're going to start seeing some results.
And I'll put the link right above.
Okay.
On here.
I don't know where the links go. They go over here. They go over there. Left to right. If you're new to the channel, welcome. You'll have a blast hanging out with us. Also, if you guys haven't seen, we have merch now. VPCustoms.threadless.com, I believe. She'll also plug that in there.
Put the link in. Yep.
She has a girl set up, girl or guy, whatever you guys want to do. If you want to have I ride my own or biker chick on yours. Also, you'll see I'm always rocking the VP Customs gear. Grab a shirt. Hang out with us. If you're also new, I started in the last episode a solo cup rating for each job that we do. So we estimated the handlebar job to be a 4 solo cup job. Maybe more like 6 or 7. Give yourself some time.
In total in part 1 and part 2? Part 1 you rated at a 4.
Well, that was supposed to be for the whole job.
That was supposed to be for the whole job.
Yeah,
oh boy.
Things happen.
Four might have been just for part
for disassembly. Give yourself some time, have some patience, take some time, step away. You're gonna run into problems. But I'll try to hit every problem that we went through. We'll try to keep it real with you guys. So let's get started. Okay, so like I said, in the part one, which you can find, you check that video out, please, you'll enjoy it. We took off the gas tank, disconnected the clutch cable, took off the brake line, undid all of our connections for our controls. This is for all underneath the gas tank, and took the actual bars off. Go back, check it out, you'll see us spill some gas everywhere, it's a good time. So, today what we're going to be doing is we're going to be working on the wiring up the bars. I've already started with one side, and I'll be honest, the inside was, they didn't treat them with care. It's chunky metal in there catching the wires. It's a nightmare. So there's a method that I used. We ran a chain through to come down through, taped the wires to the chain, slowly pull. We're going to do it on this side for you guys. And I'm also going to show the de-pinning. I de-pinned one side just to get started, and I'll show you guys in depth on this side. You'll notice on the handlebars over here, they're ground down over here. I tested out to see how our grips would work. With all the powder coating that was on the bars, it was not going to spin freely. So I took some 60 grit and some 400 and even a file in some of the high spots to get it down nice and smooth. It spins freely now, but I'm also going to be throwing some silicone, some white lithium grease, something in there to help keep it spinning freely. So all stuff to look out for. If you get new grips on your new bars, you might run into the same problem as us as far as it not wanting to spin freely. And just a side note, this is our hobby, not professionals, and we just want to show you what we go through on every step of the way.
Just average people working on our own bikes.
So first step, we're going to get to de-pinning a connector. So what I'm gonna do, there is special tools for these, and guess what? I don't have it. What you can do is you take a long set of needle nose pliers, you're gonna go right in there and kind of grab it and pull it up. Okay? See how it's pulled up now? And what I use is a paper clip, smaller paper clip. You're gonna stick it in there. Okay. So you kind of feel like a little click, you push the wire in and pull it out, and there you go. Another thing that I want to say, take pictures, write it down, however you want to do it, the orientation that they're going to go back in these clips. You're going to have to put this connector back on, so make sure. What I do is I took a bunch of pictures, some of them have a white with a black line, some are just plain white. Label them in your phone, label them on a thing, however you want to remember for yourself. I did it with my phone, just do a little picture, a little arrow that says, hey idiot, white with the black line. So we're going to go through and did each one of them. I've already done it on the other side. Felt a little click. And make sure you grab the right wire. Here you go.
All right, so I want to just show them really quick,
yeah.
Closer up. So you can see the little holes above where the pins are, you're going to stick that in there and then pull the appropriate wire out that you've just stuck, because you can see.
Yeah, these are out. So, for example, again, I'm pushing in, you're gonna feel like a little bit of a...
some tension.
Yep. And then it just, like I said, it's a push. You push the wire in, because if you look at these little connectors, they have like a little like...
tab.
Yeah. Last one, all the wires are out. Now, put this to the side somewhere. You're also gonna have to get your rubber down off, which can be a little bit annoying.
That's what she said.
Pull your wires through there. Also, you're gonna have to come down through this, and you can see they just, you have to line them up so they pull out. Not hard. So for this side, it was really cut up. We had to cut back a lot of the sheathing here to get it through. But I'll show you what we fight with to go through this one. Okay, so here we are with our chain. It's just kind of like one of those necklaces that you would put in there. I mean, any kind of light chain. I've even seen people use a wire, like a thick wire. But the chain's nice because it has a little weight to it. So what I do is just put it right down through the bottom and just kind of get it started. The gravity's gonna want to take it down, so there it is. So it came right out. So I'm just gonna take some needle nose, just kind of pull it out now. All right, so I can feel it's a little rough in there.
They do a really crappy job on the
inside. Some handlebar companies claim they clean out the inside of the bars good. I doubt this company did, because it wasn't that expensive of a pair of bars. But all right, so what I'm gonna do is obviously we're gonna have to start from the top going down. I'm gonna take some electrical, kind of twist these together a little bit, not too much, so I can have some spin on them if I need to. And basically, I'm gonna take this chain, try to integrate it in with the wires far up. Because it's gonna, at some point, if we're gonna catch some stuff in there, it's gonna wanna pull. I wrap farther down onto the actual chain for some extra strength. I'll even come back up here because I don't want that break to get caught on anything. What we're gonna do is gonna have just the bars sitting here. We can have them on the table, it's fine. Tanya is gonna just kind of put a little tension on the chain as I'm pushing and spinning and pushing. She's not gonna pull too hard. Okay, easy. We're close. So, I can see the connectors now coming down through the bottom. Beautiful. I think we got them. What? Small victories. We're winning here. We're winning. Okay, right, perfect.
So we're in.
So I'm gonna take the tape off, get to the chain, and next step, what we're gonna do is the company Burley, the wires came pinned on both sides. So basically, I'm gonna attach each wire, color coordinate them, and use some heat shrink and seal them up, and then we'll put them back into the connectors and be ready for plugging them back into the main harness on the bike. All right, so when you do your wire extensions, you'll notice those little tabs we talked about, one side on one and the other, and you'll feel it. It's not exactly tight, but you'll know when it's in there. Take your heat shrink.
So you can see the one tabs on one side here, and then the other tab
top
to the
and
wing.
Bottom, basically.
Yeah, top and bottom.
Then you take your heat shrink, slide it over, make sure you're centered best you can, and just kind of work it back and forth. All right.
So basically, we're just gonna keep doing that with all the wires. Got all these to do.
And they even include a big one to wrap them all up in when we're done. A big heat shrink for it. So once we're done with those, we'll slide them all in there, and then we'll heat shrink the whole thing closed and be done with it. Can't wait to be done with it.
It's the blue one.
Picking the easiest color first.
It's my favorite color.
Is it?
Yeah, blue.
I don't know about that.
What? How do you not know my favorite color?
I know your favorite color. I don't think it's blue.
It is. What is it?
It's magenta.
What? No. Blue freak. Ouch! My damn piggy. Oh, great. You leave that up for me. Clean up your mess. Typical male.
I can't see it.
Typical male.
I need my glasses.
You don't have glasses. I have glasses.
Maybe if you were wearing your glasses, you would have caught me putting the wrong wire on.
I'm doing my work over here. You need to catch your own stuff.
Sorry, it's done. We're just waiting on Tanya.
Oh, of course. Oh, really?
I helped her blast through hers, so I took the big thing of heat shrink.
Are you kidding me right now?
All right, so next we're going to line it up with our pictures so they go back in the right way. All right, so your side, you're going to have a black starting here.
Plain black.
Okay. Black with a red line.
Okay.
Yellow with a black line.
Okay.
And white with a gray line.
Okay, it's just white. Are you sure it's gray or purple?
It's purple then. Purple.
Purple.
Call it purple. It's just very faded. Yeah, it's purple, right?
That's purple. Purple. Wow, are you colorblind?
Maybe.
So, basically I'm just putting the points through the little gasket.
It's like a weather seal.
Soon after.
All right, guys. So, we have our wires done. We got all our connectors pinned back into our little...
Yeah, those things.
These things. So these are ready to go, and then next we're going over to the clutch.
Yeah, we're
going to
go back over to the bike. We're going to go back over to the bike, and we're going to drain the transmission fluid in preparation to get the clutch cable out. While we're draining fluid, since the bike's not hot, then we'll move back up and we'll start getting the bars dry mounted up, and we're going to start rolling here quick now. Okay, guys, for the transmission on a soft tail, there's two shocks are under here, and the bolt hole is up underneath. We'll get it kind of loose here.
Coast Guard officials say as much as 131,000 gallons of heavy crude may have leaked.
All right, so we're draining, almost all done. And just like with the car oil change, I took off the top to get some ventilation. As we talked about in part one, we have the LA Choppers risers. They're 1.5 inch. We didn't have too many options when we went with these 2 inch bars. We found one that we really like, the LA Choppers, 1.5 inch. The top piece is completely flush on top, so they'll be mounted from below, and you'll have to slip in the bolts like that. So while the transmission fluid is draining, we're gonna get the bars mocked up, and we want to see a little progress, so we'll save something. So let's do that now. All right, guys, I need Tanya's muscles to get these things. No, it really would help to have two people, because we're gonna have to fish these wires back through the middle. And the bigger connector is definitely gonna prove to be a little bit of a pain.
Just hold them.
Oh my God.
Nice.
Thank you. I like them more flush with the forks, but...
Yeah, I think that looks tacky.
What's tacky about it? It's flush. It all lines up.
So I labeled my the front throttle cable with just the green thing, so I would remember where it went. Some people say you have to take the intake off. As long as you loosen it up, I think you're okay. Just to pop it out down below here. You see there's little tabs. We'll just kind of hang this up out of the way. Much taller now for it.
Day 2.
Hey guys, we're back. It's actually a couple days later. Where we left off, we were putting the throttle cables on. You saw that right before. All I did was put those throttle cables in, put on the controls, and we're just going to pick up where we left off. We still have to do the front brake line and the clutch cable and get the gas tank back on. This is all good stuff. It's going to be fun now from here on out. So let's get started. I have the throttle cables in, like as I mentioned, and they're partially adjusted, not much. I have them rooted around here and like this. And what I'm gonna use is one of those, the things for the front brake line. I'm gonna use that and hold them right there. That way they're not out here in the middle of no man's land.
Yeah, it looks silly like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, looks ridiculous. Yeah.
All right guys, so what we're gonna do next is we are going to start loosening up the exhaust so Eric can get into the areas that he needs to get into. I believe it's the transmission.
Yeah, the transmission cover.
Something
like that.
So, here we are.
Try to do this without taking the heat shields off again. And I'm not even gonna take the bolts out all the way. I'm hoping I don't have to. I'm hoping I can just have it loose enough that we can just kinda move this away. Just enough for us to be able to access this panel right here, the cover. Tanya has it like a damn sauna in here because we got a goddamn campfire going on in here.
This thing is awesome. This garage now has got to be at least 65 degrees in here.
It's 80 degrees in here minimum right now. Minimum. She has it the same that she would want the house if it was up to her.
Right now we're taking the transmission cover off.
Yep.
Yeah. Would you look at that? He's tightening it.
We don't have enough solo cups yet.
So while he's messing around with that, you know, just playing around.
Hey.
I'm gonna talk about my merch a little bit. I had some viewers request law enforcement and military shirts. So I've designed a couple for one each, and I will have them up at the end of this video. Also, I'll have a link up here in the corner to go to our merch site, and please check it out. I also have two other designs waiting to be put into the shop as well, kind of doing a few at a time, couple at a time, one at a time. Eric thinks that's the best thing to do. I just want to put them all up.
Don't overload
second.
The people.
I just want to put them up the second I get them on. So, yeah, make sure you guys check it out. They're awesome. We wanted to, you know, support our law enforcement and our military. Again, if there's any other suggestions you guys have for us, I'm down to take it. So let me know.
So I was able to loosen up the exhaust up a little bit more. I made some free room for myself. See, got some room. Drop your Allen wrench probably 3,000 times like me. All right, yeah, the two top ones were smaller.
Remember? Put that back under there?
Yeah, we're gonna put our pan back under, even though it's drained out. And this is not gonna come off easy. Probably gonna take a couple weld taps from Tanya Harding.
Is that me, Tanya? So as you can see guys, the oil's, even though we drained it out, it's still got some extra in there.
So I'm just gonna take this whole thing right out. I pre-loosened this clutch cable right on this, even though, because you're gonna have to thread it out. Sometimes you wouldn't be able to hold that all yourself, so. Bet you she wish she had gloves on now.
I don't.
Let's just thread through it out. Tony's giving it a go because our tool broke.
Finally!
Hold on to that guy. When this comes out, there's ball bearings in there. See him? I would just put that right back the way it was. That's what I do.
this. Remember, don't lose your little
retaining holder there.
That's gonna be fun getting back in, huh?
Yeah.
Then this will just, now we can hold that, because otherwise your ball bearings are gonna go flying. That's what I do. You can just take everything out if you want to. But there you go.
All right, out with the old. Get it out of here. All right. Let's kind of just route it into position over here. Hold it up over there. Just kind of hold it out of the way for me. Slide it back the exact same way the old one came out. Okay, we're back. Like I said, what we said in part one, we have a new gasket, so we'll take off this one, the old one, clean it up a little bit, and we'll get ready. All right, so the new gasket I noticed has two holes, and if you look over here, there's some alignment pins, so we'll just use those to hold our new gasket up. I went with the more expensive metal style gasket. I don't want any leaks. Look at that, holds itself.
Getting cold in here.
I'll turn the heat back on in a minute. She was baking me out. She was baking me out.
Flashback.
Oh, damn. Think for you how hot it is in here.
Oh my god, turn it off then.
Baking yourself out.
This is gonna need one of your full details there, Tanya.
Mm-hmm. I got a guy.
What the service manual says too is that this, put it back in the position you found it. If you don't put it back, I noticed that it just kind of rocks up anyway, so it has to be there. Otherwise, your clutch adjustment is going to be all thrown off.
Okay, guys, well, our tool broke that we were using to take this in and out, so, but we got it back. We called my dad downstairs for a third set of hands. Yeah. We muscled that baby back in, so if you see, it's all the way forward, and if you were to pull in the clutch, that's how it would roll. It rolls up and it engages like that. And that's what, for those of you who don't know, that's what pushes up against that for the clutch to activate.
What did we say, the bottom ones you picked? On top. Getting her leg up into it.
Hey, I don't have anyone's help here holding the pipes here.
I was taking a red solo cup break.
Did you pull on your pipes there?
They're my pipes. Right. Those are done.
All the way tight? Everything?
Everything.
And you tightened it
though. Why do you look surprised?
And you tightened it the 1, 2, 4. There's like a tightening pattern, just like the owner's manual, like we talked about. Yep.
That's it.
Beautiful. Let's fill it up with some fluid.
Alright.
We're going with a Maxima. I like Maxima stuff. It says it takes like 20 to 24 ounces.
How about I hold this so you can just concentrate on that?
Slow. I really hope it comes back out and hit your arm.
Yeah, that's mean.
He's just jealous because I don't wear gloves and I can get away with it and not have a problem with getting my hands dirty.
Once you start wearing gloves, you'll never go back.
I don't know about that. Maybe it'd be smarter to do it like that. Dun dun dun.
Wait a minute, you were holding the funnel.
You started it.
We're gonna stick with that for now and we'll check it after. Alright, so we got our transmission cover tightened up. Going over to the lever now. Get that up here in the handlebar.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we're gonna have to adjust this now.
Okay, so we got our new front brake line here. Came with some nice new crush washers and a new banjo bolt. All black stuff. And don't have to worry about the 12 points because these are 6 now. Little things, right?
It's always the little things.
Always the little things. Down here. All of our stuff is strategically routed. We don't look like morons with the big cables flying out all over the place.
hear that? Our kids are out of control.
They're out of control up there.
It like sounds like a stampede up there.
All right, so we're going to take off our cover for our master cylinder. I'm going to fill up some brake fluid here. I don't know if you remember in part one, this thing was trashed on the inside. There was junk all in there. I cleaned it all out with a brake cleaner. It's a lot better in there now. It's just a little corroded looking. I got some brand new dot five. You have to use dot five. Oh, look at that color. That's interesting. I don't remember seeing purple before. We're just going to kind of let that sit. Gravity bleed. Some air out. Just let that hang out while we're working on the rest of the bike. I have the wiring plugs plugged right back into their stock spot. I'm just going to take the extra and just zip tie it up out of the way. Okay guys, we got our wires cleaned up under here. I have this button back up. We're ready to put the gas tank on. It's time. Now we're going to start seeing some good shit.
Yeah. What happened to no cursing?
Whoops. Go back to part one. You won't see us spill any gas for professionals here. Don't forget to hook up your vent line. All these things tight. We'll hook up our fuel lines. Cross over to your back. And get ready to spill some gas.
Let's not do that again, please.
We must have lost it all in the first video.
Definitely.
We're back. Just minor on the floor. Yep. I don't think I understand why they have to use flatheads on these, and they can't just use the Phillips head so you can stab your finger a million times while you're taking these things off. Alright, well, we're going to plug back in our main fuel line here. A little pressure. We're back. Alright. Let's get the bezel back on. If you remember from the first video, that fought us a lot. I was able to salvage the carriage bolt, and we bent up the tabs. We'll be good to go here. We're gonna plug our bezel back in, all the connections. Lights are on, we're doing good so far. We got just the battery just halfway mocked up. We gotta plug that in for real.
Good detail.
Gotta get your rags out.
Cheers.
Tanya's gonna get her mirrors on now. Lock washer on top. Just got this down, I didn't tell her anything. How do you like them? How do you like those mirrors?
I love the mirrors.
I think they're pretty cool.
Yeah.
Amazon special, but they're pretty cool. Pizza's here.
Ooh, I'm hungry.
Perfect timing.
Cool.
And those babies in a little bit like that, so you can actually see.
Yeah, well, I mean, nothing's tightened. Everything's got to get adjusted.
Okay, I think the next step is we just have to finish bleeding these brakes here, front brakes.
Oh man.
And give this thing a quick detail. We're not gonna show it yet, though. We're not gonna show the whole bike yet.
Yeah, no, not yet. No. But she's a bad bitch.
Tanya hasn't even sat on this thing yet. So let's get her first reaction sitting on the bike. I know she's excited for this.
Oh my god, and it's such a difference.
Yeah.
Pulling the bike up.
Just taking the bike off the lift. It felt so much better with the mini Apes on it.
This is amazing.
You love it?
I love it.
Those things are beefy. Yeah, it looks good.
definitely looks good.
I don't want to get off it now.
No, I know. Let's go for a ride.
Go for a ride.
The roads are all covered
like
in ice.
0 degrees out. It's perfect height. It's so perfect.
Yeah, it is perfect. It does. Your arms are completely level. And it had, the bike has like the perfect amount of mixture of black and chrome.
Yeah, I was a little worried about
the pipes.
With
the forks, yeah.
That way, but it actually doesn't.
It
really
looks
look
pretty
that
good.
Bad.
Remember, we can always wrap things.
You look awesome.
We did it.
We did it.
It was a lot of work.
And you know, we just want to take a second here to thank both sets of our parents so much for this project here. Her parents came over a couple times. My parents have been here. Her dad came out and helped out once or twice off camera, and my dad came down a bunch of times off camera and just kind of helped us through when we needed that third set of hands.
Yes.
Her expertise, you know.
So we hope you guys love it, because we love it so much. And it's definitely something you're gonna have to have patience for if you're doing the first time.
Just pay somebody the $400 to do it yourself. Don't do it. Just pay somebody.
That's not the fun part though. You wanna be challenged. Then you do it, you know, because that's what you do. That's what you do when you have your own bikes.
Yeah,
so you challenge yourself.
Work on them ourselves.
You do it and you get through it, and then
but do it in the winter.
In the end.
Do it in the winter when you're not worried about missing out on rides.
Yeah, that too.
All right, guys, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and one other thing, if you can, share with your friends, because when you share, it really helps for some reason that weird algorithm. So, thanks again for watching.